Good morning, children. Today we are going to see the part 4 of the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance. So yesterday we covered Griffith experiment, that is the transforming principle. So today we are going to see the next experiment, Blender's experiment. It was conducted by two scientists, Hershey and Chase. Okay, so here by means of this experiment, they were able to prove that DNA is the genetic material. What the Griffith, her followers, they were able to tell DNA could be doing the transformation principle. But by means of experiment, this experiment, Blender's experiment, so they were able to conclude. So DNA is the genetic material. Okay, so when it is asked in exam, so DNA is the genetic material, how it was proved? So then you have to write this Blender's experiment. Here these two scientists, Hershey and Chase, in 1952, they worked with the bacteria and bacteriophage. So bacteriophage is a type of virus, it infects the bacteria. Okay, so that's why you call that as bacteriophage. So actually, how do they do the infection, this bacteriophage? So this is a bacteriophage. So it is having, you know, what that is already you studied in 11, the structure of bacteriophage. So what do they do? It is having the outside protein coat and the inside DNA. So this is the bacteria. When it infects the bacteria, so actually what do? They inject the DNA inside the cell. Okay, so here by using this principle, they were doing the experiment. So here the viral genetic material, what does it do when it infects the bacteria? It becomes the integral part of the bacterial genome. And actually what do? The bacteria, it manufactures the viral particle by using host machinery, that is the virus, it has introduced its DNA. So this DNA, it will make the virus to produce, it will make the bacteria to produce viral DNA. Okay, so here this is the experiment. So how it was proved, let us see here, how do they work upon. So finally, what did they discover? This scientist, they worked together, Hershey and Chase, they finally they proved. So it is now DNA is the genetic material that only entered inside the virus but not the protein. So they were able to conclude. So now let us the Blender's experiment. Say they grow some viruses on a medium. Okay, so having radioactive phosphorus, they grown viruses in a medium containing radioactive phosphorus. One group of viruses, they were grown like that. So when some other group, they were grown in the medium of radioactive sulfur. One group of viruses, they were grown in radioactive phosphorus, and the other group, they were grown in radioactive sulfur. The viruses, the grown in radioactive phosphorus, so they became, these viruses, so they were able to take the phosphorus, and the phosphorus, it became a part of DNA. Okay, so actually the phosphorus, that is DNA, it is made up of the nucleotide. It contains nitrogenous base, sugar and phosphate bond. So that's why the phosphorus, it was taken by the DNA. It has become the integral part, that radioactive phosphorus. And the viruses, the grown in radioactive sulfur, sulfur is a part of protein. So that's why the protein coat, it has taken the sulfur. So that's why that viruses, second group of viruses, the radioactivity, they be able to show in protein coat, as the sulfur is a part of protein. Okay, so here these two group of viruses, the first group of viruses, you can see they have colored. So when you see, this sulfur, the protein, the protein coat, as it is having the radioactive sulfur, so this red color it has been shown, and here in green color it has been shown the radioactive phosphorus DNA in the part of green color it has been shown. Okay, so here in this group the radioactivity is shown in DNA, and this group the radioactivity is shown in protein coat. Both of them, they were done in two separate experiments. For this group of bacteriophage, they were allowed to infect bacteria, and the other group of bacteriophage, it was allowed to infect other group of bacteria. Three steps are there. First step is infection, second step is blending, and the third step is centrifugation. So actually in infection step, the bacteria, that they were infected affected by the bacteriophage, that is the infection stage. So during this infection stage, you can see here they are introducing the DNA inside. Here you can see in black color, it is not having radioactivity. Actually, the protein coat is having the radioactivity. So here also you can see they are injecting the DNA. While infection, this bacteriophage, they inject the DNA inside. And the second step is blending. So by means of the blending step, the bacteria and the viral particles, they were separated by means of agitating in a blender. Okay, so here you can see in the second step, so both of them, they are getting separated. Only DNA is seen inside the bacterial cell. So here also in green color, as it is no radioactivity, so here the black color not having the radioactivity. Okay, so it is the second step. And the third step is centrifugation. After that, the virus particle, after separation, it was spinned in a centrifuge machine. You know the principle of centrifugation. In centrifugation, when it is rotated, so what happens? So actually, the particles according to their weight, that is heaviness, it has been separated. You know the separation of butter from buttermilk. Okay, when you are here by means of your mom, you must have observed how she is separating butter from the buttermilk. So while separating, so automatically the butter, as it is light in weight, it will float, so it can be separated the same way. So here also the same principle. So viral particles are light in weight, they will float above, and the bacterial particles are heavy, they will be settling down. Okay, so when it was observed and observation, so after the first step is infection, second step is blending, third step is centrifugation. Okay, so on centrifugation, what was their observation? Actually, the bacteria infected virus, the bacteria infected viruses, so which was having the radioactive DNA. Okay, so they were not showing the radioactivity in supernatant. Actually, why they were not showing radioactivity? This group of bacteria, so the second group, so they were showing the radioactivity in the sediment, not in the supernatant. Why is it like that? Because the bacteria settles down and the DNA is there inside the bacteria. As it is, bacteria is heavier, it settles down, and only the sediment, it was showing the radioactivity. But not the bacteriophage, that is a supernatant. You can get only the bacteriophage, as it is light in weight and it is not having the radioactivity floating above. So on the second set of experiment, the radioactivity was observed in the supernatant. So why it is like that in this activity? So the radioactivity was observed in the supernatant. Why? Because the radioactivity was given in the protein coat. As it is given the protein coat, the bacteriophage will be floating in the supernatant. So when as the supernatant was showing radioactivity and the bacteria, they were not showing the radioactivity, because here the DNA is not coated by the radioactive material. Okay, so here what was the conclusion? Finally, they were able to tell. So the DNA is the infecting agent that made the bacteria it was able to make the viral protein, viral DNA, and then that actually the viral DNA entered inside, it modified bacterial DNA, and from there only the viral particles were synthesized. Okay, so here actually the viral DNA entered inside, what it will do, it will associate with the bacterial DNA and it will make the bacterial DNA, they will make their own DNA, and later the bacteria will undergo lysis, that is they will break and they will liberate the bacteriophage. Okay, so here ultimately by means of this experiment, that is DNA is the genetic material and protein is not the genetic material. So that is the Hershey and Chase experiment, and it proved DNA is the genetic material. Okay, this is the second experiment. The same way it can be asked in 3 mocks also, as it is having 3 steps, and sometimes it can be asked in 5 mocks. So entire thing along with the conclusion, if they ask, it will become in 5 mocks. Then with the help of diagram and along with explanation, you can explain children. It is both the experiments, whatever we studied, the group experiment also, and the second experiment is Hershey and Chase experiment. Actually, sometimes you confuse So that's why you have to be clear, read the question carefully before answering. When it is they are asking transforming principle, you have to explain the Griffith experiment. So when they are asking for DNA is the genetic material, then you have to tell the Hershey and Chase experiment. Okay children, still if they are having any doubt, then you can contact me. Thank you children, we will meet in the next class.